Welcome to my seventh tutorial on resistive circuits. In this video, we'll discuss one problem from GATE 2015 ECE set number 1. And you look at the problem. So in this circuit, you'll see there is one current source 5 ampere. The independent current source, but the circuit will contain two dependent sources. So one dependent current source, depending on the voltage across this 20 ohm resistance, and another dependent voltage source, again it is depending on the same potential across 20 ohm. Okay, so this dependent current source will provide 5 times Vx current, and the dependent voltage source will provide 0.25 Vx, right? And here 10 ohm resistance between these two nodes and 8 ohm across this dependent source. So this is the circuit. Now here we need to find out the potential Vx. And I think it is a simple circuit, very simple to solve. Now you see the approach. So what we'll do? So first of all, we should read out the circuit in our convenient way. Okay. So first of all, this one, there's a pure voltage source. A pure voltage source, and across the pure voltage source, there is one resistance. So whatever resistance value it is, the node, this two node will have a gap of 0.25 Vx. So this node potential will depend on this dependent source only. It does not depend on this 8 ohm resistance at all. Okay. So if I want to find out the node potential here, there this 8 ohm resistance will not play any role. So that thing we have discussed in my previous lectures. That if you have a pure voltage source, and across the pure voltage source, if you have some resistance or current source, those things we can ignore. We can just remove if we want to calculate some other parameters like voltage or current in some other side, right? So this 8 ohm resistance will remove first. It is not useful. And here you will see these are the same node. That is the important thing. This node and this node actually they are same because there is no element here. So don't be confused, right? And so I'll read out the circuit. You see that I'll take one node here only. There one 5 ampere current source entering, and from that node only this 5 Vx current source is leaving, right? And I'll remove this 8 ohm resistance. So what is your read on circuit? So I'll consider this, I'll draw this one, this resistance first. Okay. And then I'll have one resistance here. This is a node. And there. So I remove this 8 ohm resistance. I will not connect. I'll just only use this one. So this node same. So I'll consider this node only. Right? And this node. This is grounded. So this is your 0.25 Vx, and this potential is Vx. This resistance is 20 ohm. This is your 10 ohm. Right. Now I'll add this current source, independent current source here. It is 5 ampere. And a dependent current source from here to here, the same node. Let's say dependent current source, this, right? This is your 5 Vx. So with respect to this one, this node potential is Vx, because the gap between these two, so these two end, the gap is Vx, and one end is grounded, so this node potential is Vx. Now here, at this node, I can take KCL, right? In this node, 5 ampere current is coming, 5 Vx is leaving. So the current through this branch, 20 ohm, is Vx upon 20. And current through this branch will be, so what is the potential here? The potential here is 0.25 Vx, because there is a pure voltage source here. So this end is 0 and this end should be 0.25 Vx only. So everything is known. Just I need to apply one KCL here, find one equation to solve for Vx. Right? So what to do? So can I write one equation here, the Vx, applying KCL here? Right? So you see here, the incoming current is 5 ampere. Okay? So that I'll take positive, 5 ampere incoming. That is equals to all outgoing. Okay, so this, from this point, there is one current leaving, 5 Vx. I think here, it is not 5 Vx. This is 0.5 Vx, okay? It is 0.5. So this current source, current is 0.5. So it is 0.5 Vx. The leaving, and leaving through this 20 ohm resistance will be Vx upon 20 plus the current through this 10 ohm resistance would be Vx minus 0.25 Vx upon 10. Just you need to solve this equation and you will get Vx. Very simple. So can I solve this one? It is 5. Now this will be, so can I consider it is 20 LCM, then it is 10 Vx. So this one, then it is Vx plus this is 2 Vx minus 2 times 0.5 Vx. Right, so you see this one is coming at 13 minus 0.5, 12.5 Vx equal to 20 times 5. So Vx will be this 20 times 5 upon 12.5. Right, so 5 is a 2.5. And this is 8, is 20. So Vx is 8 volt. Okay, so this is the answer, 8 volt. So it's a very simple problem. So please try to understand this one. And in future, we'll be adding more problems. And please go through my future videos and subscribe my channel. And I hope you'll understand all the concept. Thank you.